Hey everyone, this is a bit of a special Simply Explained video with me talking about my DIY home energy monitor. You see, I was interested in knowing how much electricity our whole apartment was using, and I wanted to collect that data over time. Now, of course, I could just periodically write down the numbers on my meter, but that's not cool. Instead, I wanted something automated and connected to the internet. So I went out and bought a CT sensor and a microcontroller to build sort of like a Fitbit for my electricity consumption. And yes, I do realize that there are commercial products available that do the same thing, but these are often expensive and require a subscription. Besides, doing it myself is a fun exercise to learn about microcontrollers, the cloud, and CT sensors. I started by ordering all the parts from AliExpress. That is a microcontroller. I chose the ESP32, a CT sensor, a display, a few resistors, capacitors, protoboards, and some female headphone jacks. The total cost of all of this was a little over 20 euros. You might wonder why I bought headphone jacks. Well, that's because the sensor I bought, this one, uses a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack as a connector. And I thought it would be nice to integrate this into a case, but more on that later. Once everything arrived, I soldered this little circuit onto a protoboard. It basically connects the CT sensor to the microcontroller, cleans up the signal, and makes sure that we can safely read out its measurements. This sensor is actually a little clip that goes around the main wire of your house. They are non-invasive. You don't have to cut any wires to put a special sensor in between, and that's a good thing because messing around with high voltages is potentially dangerous and, at least here in Belgium, requires you to have it reviewed by a professional. But you might wonder, if a CT sensor is not in direct contact with electricity, how can it still sense how much current is going through a wire? Well, this wouldn't be a Simply Explained video without some juicy explanations. The first thing you need to know is that when an electrical current flows through a copper wire, it generates a magnetic field around the wire that is proportional to the current flowing through it. This was first discovered in 1823 by André-Marie Ampère. Now, CT stands for current transformer, and as the name suggests, it transforms this magnetic field into a second, smaller current. And this particular model goes even further and converts that current into a voltage between 0 and 1 volts, which we can easily measure with a microcontroller. And again, the output of a CT sensor is proportional. This model can sense up to 30 amps of current flowing through a wire, at which point it will output 1 volt. If, however, we measure half a volt on its output, then we know that 15 amps are flowing through the main wire. Once we know the current, we can calculate how many watts we draw by using Ohm's law. Just multiply the amps with the voltage on the grid, which in Europe is 230 volts. And once you have that, you can calculate how many watts you've used per hour, which is the same metric that the power companies use to bill you. Except that they use kilowatt hours, so you have to divide by 1,000. So that is how the sensor works. Back to the DIY project. I wanted everything to be housed in a nice enclosure, so I fired up Fusion 360 and this is what I came up with. I designed a case with a top lid that is screwed into place and has a cutout for the display. On the side, there are two cutouts, one for the headphone jack and one for a micro USB port to power the microcontroller. And inside the case, I've added several standoffs to securely mount everything. Once this was finished, I sent it to my 3D printer, assembled everything, et voila, the hardware was done. Next, I wrote some Arduino code for the ESP32 to read out the CT sensor and show the current energy consumption on the display. Having a real-time display is fun, but not enough. The ESP32, however, has built-in Wi-Fi, which means I could use it to send the readings to the cloud. To do that, I've used the AWS IoT service to set up kind of like a chat channel between my ESP and AWS. Every second, the energy consumption is measured, and every 30 seconds, those readings are sent up to Amazon. Once it arrives there, Amazon writes these readings into a DynamoDB table for safekeeping. Alright, I'm almost done. The last step towards world domination, energy monitoring,
is to create a little app to visualize the data that is stored inside this DynamoDB table. And this is where I landed on. On the homepage, I can see how much electricity is currently being used, as well as how much electricity has been used so far today. I also try to calculate the standby power, which is the amount of power that is always being used by devices that are always plugged in, like the fridge or the TV. On the second tab, I can see the raw readings over time, and the final screen shows us our consumption over the last 30 days. We are currently using between 4 and 6 kilowatt hours of electricity every day. Cool, right? Okay, but how accurate is this thing? Well, it should be fairly close to what your meter says, but it's of course not 100% accurate. This sensor only measures current flowing through a wire, which is called true power. It does, however, not measure reactive power. And there's also some accuracy lost from converting the magnetic field into a secondary current. But in my case, it's actually fairly close to the consumption on my electricity bill. All in all, this was a fun project, and I'd like to continue to improve it in the future. One feature I'd like to add is the ability to add multiple CT sensors so you can keep track of the output of your solar panels, for instance. But that's for another video. In the meantime, you can check out the link to my blog post in the video description. It contains more technical details and the source code should you want to build this yourself. Oh, and before you click away, let me know in the comments below what you thought of this video and if you want to see more simply explained DIY projects. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and consider getting subscribed. And as always, thank you very much for watching.